Hello all. Now we will begin with the evolution of the vertebrates. Like there are three vertebrates in our syllabus. So the first one is this, the evolutionary trend in hominidae. Right. So we covered till here. Right. We covered the basic difference between invertebrate and vertebrate in the last part. So like this is also another topic I want to take. Right. Let me zoom it for you. I hope the recording is on. Yes, it is on. Right. So, see, now we are studying the vertebrates, right? The organisms which have backbone, which includes fishes, amphibian, reptile, mammal, and birds, right? So, sometimes, I expect that, especially in IFS, sometimes they can ask, especially in the short question, the compulsory one, that describe the characteristics of vertebrata. Till now, I don't think it has been asked in IS as well as IFS, but this has been asked a couple of times in GSI exam. So, like, I think that this is a very basic question. This can even be asked in interview, right? In the IFS or CSE interview, especially if you have a background in geology. Otherwise, they don't ask many questions from geology in interview, right? But just for better preparedness, I just covered this then some basic characteristics of vertebrata. So see, vertebrata are the more modern organism. Like when life evolved in ocean, it was very primitive. Like it was initially, it was microscopic, then it became megascopic, but it was still invertebrate, very simple life form. They don't have much of complex internal structures. They don't have much of the skeleton or the muscle. Very simple morphology, right? They also don't have much developed organs or the important life driving this systems, like blood and circulatory systems, right? So these are the characteristic of vertebrata. What? Firstly, all the vertebrates have bilateral symmetry. That is, the one side of there is mirror image of the other side. So a very simple thing. Like they all have complex internal structures. They have skeletons. They have muscles, right? Like we have bones. How many bones do we have? We humans normally have like up to 206 bones, right? So it is a very complex system. Similarly, we have various well-defined organs. Like we have, brain. We have eye, ear, nose. We have spinal cord. We have very well-defined organs present for specific purposes. Then we have this vertebrata with time developed lungs, especially the terrestrial animals, and all those animals which lived on the water, they developed gills, right? So that is also a breathing organ. Right. So this was something which was happening. And they have, a well-defined blood and circulatory system. So these are some very basic vertebrata. If you have this, you can keep this in mind. You can even generate more points from your own side, and you won't be caught off guard in the examination, right? And then this is also something which I think has been asked once in IFS, I think in early 2010s. So like they asked, and this is also given in NCERT. This is something which can be asked in even GS prelims. Right, and something which is given in 12th geography NCERT, that how life evolves, right? This we discussed in the last part also, that the when life evolved, it was, it evolved from very basic cyanobacteria, right? So it was a microscopic kind of a organism. Then life evolved from this prokaryotes, it became eukaryote. Then there was, multicellular organism. Then similarly, what happens, organ development happened. Some tissues, they form brain and they started, developing on a particular part of the body. Then other digestive system, circulatory system, they started to build up. Lungs and gills, stronger lungs and gills, they started coming up. So this is how life evolved. So in terms of phyla or the class, right, this is all vertebrata. Phyla, also known as chordata, and classes are either fishworm, and these are the four tetrapods. Amphibian, these are all class. Reptiles, mammals, and birds. So, of all these, the first one is the fishes, which they evolved. They came up on the earth. So, they are the oldest and they have the gills, right? From fishes, लाइफ फॉर्म स्लोली ग्रेजुअली दे स्टार्टेड कमिंग फ्रॉम ओशियन टू दी लैंड राइट, बट देवर फ्लेक्सिबल, दे कुड ऑल्सो गो बैक टू दी ओशियन, सो देवर दी एम्फीबियंस राइट. फ्रॉम एम्फीबियंस देयर कम्स ऑर्गेनिजम्स नोन एज दी रैप्टाइल्स विच कुड लिव इन दी वॉटर, विच कुड लिव कंप्लीटली ऑन द लैंड राइट. सो इट इज ऑल्सो नॉट द केस दैट फर्स्ट रेप्टाइल केम अप, ओनली देन मैमल देन बर्ड्स. ऑल दिस इवोल्यूशन वॉज टेकिंग प्लेस ग्रेजुअली वैन इवन इन द टाइम्स ऑफ यू नो द सिलोरियन एंड डेवोनियन टाइम्स इन जियोलॉजिकल टाइम स्केल वैन यू नो दिस वॉज वी से दैट इट इज एन एज ऑफ फिश. दीज वर द एजेस एज ऑफ फिशेज राइट. इवन एट दैट टाइम सम वेरी प्रिमिटिव एम्फीबियंस स्टार्टेड टू डेवलप राइट. सिमिलरली लाइक वी से दैट मीजोजोइक एरा इज द एरा अ टाइम ऑफ रेप्टाइल्स राइट. सो इट डज नॉट मीन दैट ओनली रेप्टाइल्स इनहैबिटेड प्लैनेट अर्थ. इवन एट दैट टाइम देयर वर सम मैमल्स यू नो द फर्स्ट बर्ड आर्कियोप्टेरिक्स वी से दैट इट इज अ लिंक बिटवीन द रेप्टाइल एंड द बर्ड्स. इट्स इट ऑल्सो केम अप समवेयर इन मीजोजोइक ओनली राइट. इवन इन द मीजोजोइक टाइम देयर वर सम मैमल्स ऑल्सो लाइक इन क्रिटेशियस इवन इन जुरासिक टाइम देयर वर सम मैमल्स बट देवर वेरी वेरी प्रिमिटिव एंड देवर वेरी वेरी यू कैन से देवर लाइक रोडेंट लाइक मैमल्स राइट. सो लाइक दोज मैमल्स द फर्स्ट मैमल देवर दे आर द एंसेस्टर ऑफ ऑल द मॉडर्न मैमल्स. मॉडर्न मैमल्स मीन्स बीट ह्यूमन बीट कैट डॉग हॉर्स एलिफेंट वी ऑल हैव अ कॉमन एंसेस्टर एंड इट वॉज यू नो प्रिटी मच लाइक मॉडर्न रोडेंट. इट इज नॉट द मॉडर्न रोडेंट विच इज अवर एंसेस्टर बट इट इट लुक समथिंग लाइक द मॉडर्न रोडेंट एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दिस आफ्टर कपल ऑफ स्लाइड्स राइट. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस पार्ट. सो अगेन दिस इज जस्ट अ डिटेल ऑफ वॉट एवर वी डिस्कस्ड राइट. सो राइट. सो लाइक वी डिस्कस फिशेज दीज आर कंसिडर्ड एज द ओल्डेस्ट वर्टिब्रेट्स. लाइक फॉर गिव मी फॉर माई बैड हैंड राइटिंग बट दीज वर जस्ट माई शॉर्ट नोट्स विच आई प्रिपेयर फॉर लास्ट मिनट रिविजन और मे बी द सेकेंड लेयर ऑफ माई नोट्स राइट. सो द अर्लिएस्ट फिशेज वर बोनी. द अर्लिएस्ट फिशेज वर बोनी दे हैड अ स्केलेटन समथिंग लाइक दैट लाइक सो एंड देन दे डेवलप्ड दे इवॉल्व to be more adaptive to the surrounding right. And the earliest fishes are also known as agnatha fishes right. Agnatha, this word generally means jawless. This generally means jawless right. So they were the jawless fishes right. Then similarly we have the next we have amphibians and they first appeared in the Devonian time period. They first appeared in the Devonian time period and we can say that they are basically the link between the marine and terrestrial animals right. Just we discussed it. Then we have reptile. They were the first to colonize the land right. So they developed various adaptive mechanism to reproduce and live on the land. Like they developed shells on their egg, so which helped them to prevent the loss of moisture to desiccation, to prevent the desiccation from the sun's heat, right? And we know they are cold-blooded. They have scale for protection of their skins. And dinosaurs are one of the most famous example of reptiles. Then we have mammals. So mammals are those animals which give birth to their young ones. Which gives direct birth to their young ones, right? So they actually evolved from an offshoot of reptiles only in Upper Triassic, like in Mesozoic. What we have Triassic, Jurassic, and we have Cretaceous. So it is somewhere here mammals started. To develop, they first developed from reptile, you know, from one of the reptile only. And here we say that we have the first, we can call मैमल, वी हैव यू नो समवेयर हियर वी हैव द फर्स्ट कॉमन एंसेस्टर ऑफ मैमल्स, राइट? सो दे आर लाइक वार्म ब्लडेड, राइट? एंड एंड लाइक दिस इज जस्ट जनरल नॉलेज दैट मैमल्स आर जनरली ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स ना. द मोस्ट कॉमन मैमल, लाइक 98% ऑफ द मैमल्स आर प्लेसेंटल. Like I know you, placental means they give birth to their young ones. They give directly direct birth to their young ones. Then we also have some as marsupials. Can you recall where do you find these marsupials? These marsupials are those mammals which have pouch like structure where they carry their young ones. Like the most famous example of them is the kangaroo. These marsupials are also found in South America, right? Some marsupials are also found in South America, but more than 95% of the species of these marsupials, they are found in the continent of Australia, right? Similarly, these mammals, they are also egg-laying, all right? Egg-laying mammals. So you must have heard about ना प्लेटिपस, डक बिल्ड प्लेटिपस. तो इट इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एग लेइंग मैमल्स. सो इन अ वे एक्चुअली दीज आर जस्ट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ मोस्ट एंशियंट, मोस्ट यू नो प्रिमिटिव मैमल्स. प्रेजेंटली मोस्ट ऑफ द मैमल्स आर प्लेसेंटल, राइट? सो दिस इज जस्ट सम वेरी बेसिक. एंड देन सिमिलरली दीज आर द एवियन स्पीशीज, दैट इज द बर्ड्स. सो लाइक द वन ऑफ द फर्स्ट बर्ड विच वी लाइक कॉल इज दिस आर्कियोप्टेरिक्स. सम बुक्स categorize this Archaeopteryx as reptiles, right? But some books say that this is a link between the birds and the reptile, right? So these birds also evolved from these reptiles only in Upper Jurassic, right? And the earliest birds, like they were very early, they were primitive, they were had to have a lot of adaptation. So they even had teeth, right? And their bones were not hollow, so they were a bit, you know, they were a bit heavy. But the modern birds, as we all know that, they don't have teeth. Like their teeth is modified into beak, right? And also their bones are hollow. You know, mostly their horns, bones are hollow bones. So because of this, they can even fly pretty easily. So like this was a very simplistic thing. So now this is our main topic. That is the evolutionary trend in hominidae. So this hominidae is nothing but this is man. So we want to study how we humans, how this human species has evolved, right? So we have to just trace the ancestors and we just have to understand few important characteristics. And our topic is not just evolution, it is evolutionary trend. So we need to observe what changes are happening from our most ancient ancestor to the modern times, what changes have happened, right? So all those changes, we just need to remember the keywords and we need to produce all of those in our answers. So like I have specific slide made for this, but these are my, you know, old notes. These are my old notes. So I am just giving you as a brief overview that we will devote at least an hour and a half for this topic. But ultimately, you should have a very concise notes. And this evolutionary trends in hominidae has to be not in more than 2 to 3 pages, right? Like this, whatever we will read, ultimately you can put it in a diagram. This is a diagram, right? So I'm sorry for this rough kind of a slide, but this I just want to show you. This was a rough slide of mine only. I just happened to put it in the slide. So something like this. So this is Homo sapiens. This is us. So what we are studying in evolutionary trend is one thing, we are studying about the names. So presently we are called Homo sapiens. Before that there was something which is known as Homo erectus. Like, so don't worry about these keywords. We will study it so many times. We will see it so many times that you will be comfortable with the scientific name, right? So these are just 10-12 names which you, if you remember, it will give you about 90% marks in this question. And this question, like we discussed in previous question analysis, these are very, very recurrent, right? So you just have to remember a few basic trends which you can, you know, decipher from your general IQ itself after going through the class. And if you remember this 10-12 names, you will get almost full marks, pretty much like mathematics, right? So I have also simplified it for you in this phylogenetic diagram. So we call this diagram as cladogram. A cladogram is something which is more complex, but you can call it cladogram, or you can call it phylogenetic diagram, or you can call it evolutionary tree. Okay, so just don't worry, I'll go through in details of each and everything, but just to make you comfortable with few names, I'm saying this. So this is Homo sapiens. Then we have some species like Neanderthal, Cro-Magnon. Now it is not visible here due to bad picture, but don't worry, it will come. Then we have something like Australopithecus. We have something like Ramapithecus, Canthropus, and then we have the earliest and the oldest man-like fossil, man-like species, Propylopithecus. Then it has some other branches. Now it branched into Proconsul, Dryopithecus. From there came the modern apes, the chimpanzees, the gorilla, the orangutans, right? So we'll see it, but this is just a sample, something which we need to produce in the exam. So if there is a question on, you know, 10 marker question, you can just draw this diagram and scrub few points on it. If it is a 15 or 20 or 25 marker question in IFS or IAS, right, then you just draw this diagram and just write something about all these species which we will discuss in detail. So this is the final output I was discussing about, right? But don't worry, we are yet to start the topic. So like, just to explain you, I'll share ki what actually is happening, right? So okay, we will just go through ki what actually the scenario is, what are the conditions in which this evolution is happening, right? So we'll write it here. So like, we'll trace this evolution of humans from this KT boundary. What is KT boundary? Like, KT is actually, this is Cretaceous time period, right? And this is tertiary, right? So this is Mesozoic era and this is Cenozoic era. So at the boundary of Mesozoic and Cenozoic, what happened? You must be aware that there was a mass extinction. There was a mass extinction. About like more than 70% of the species on the planet Earth, they got extinct. They got disappeared forever. Right. So this Mesozoic era was the era of reptiles. Other species were also there, but it was the mighty dinosaurs which dominated the earth till this time in the Mesozoic era. Right. The species, like, you must have heard about T-Rex, the mighty T-Rex. It used to inhabit the planet Earth in this time. But what happened is, this boundary is due to whatever reasons that we'll discuss. So that is not important in this context. So there was a mass extinction, and what happens is that this T-Rex got vanished at this boundary, right? Along with this T-Rex, there were some mammals, right? Like we discussed. So there were some very primitive rodent like mammals, right? Mammals. So you can say these most primitive rodent like mammals, they're in Cretaceous, but they also happened to live in the Cenozoic time also. Like, they didn't go extinct. A lot of other mammals, a lot of other, you know, species, they did go extinct, but this most primitive rodent like mammal, they happened to survive this mass extinction period, right? So from this rodent like mammal, the common, which we can call as the common ancestor, right, what evolved were the first primates. Like, somebody asked in class, sir, what are primates? प्राइमेट्स आर वॉट? प्राइमेट्स आर बेसिकली मंकी लाइक क्रिएचर, लाइक इफ यू इफ यू हैव टू गिव सम एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मॉडर्न प्राइमेट्स, लाइक मंकी वुड बी एन एग्जाम्पल फॉर दैट, लाइक मंकी लाइक एंसेस्टर, दे आर प्रेटी मच लाइक मॉडर्न मंकीज, बट लाइक दे आर नॉट एक्चुअली द मॉडर्न मंकीज, लाइक मॉडर्न मंकीज ऑल्सो इवॉल्व फ्रॉम दीज प्राइमेट्स ओनली. बट ऑल राइट, सो फ्रॉम दिस फर्स्ट प्राइमेट वॉट वी हैव इज वी हैव दिस मंकी लाइक, वी हैव द फर्स्ट मंकी लाइक एंसेस्टर, लाइक दे आर इवन मोर प्रिमेटिव, बट देन फ्रॉम हियर वी हैव दिस मंकी लाइक एंसेस्टर्स. एंड फ्रॉम दीज मंकी लाइक एंसेस्टर्स वी हैव वॉट वी हैव, देर वॉज अ लीनिएज टूवर्ड्स एप्स, द मॉडर्न एप्स, एंड वी हैव द लीनिएज टूवर्ड्स द मॉडर्न मंकीज. So, what are the example of modern apes? Can you recall name of few modern apes? Like I say that we have C, G, and we have O. We also have something we call it bonobos. If you know about it, these are right. So we have bonobos. So CGO is what? C is for chimpanzees. G is for gorillas, right? So and O is for orangutan, right? So from apes we have this bonobos. From here only, actually these chimpanzees. Let me draw it even in a more clear manner, right? So it is something like this. From apes we have the modern gorillas, right? We have modern gorillas. From here itself there was a branching, and from one of the branch we have orangutans. And from here we have what? Chimpanzees. And this is also we have what? We have bonobos. Like if you will see the genetic studies, the most genetically closer species on earth to humans, these are these two, chimpanzees and bonobos. We have about 95 to 97% DNA similarities with these two species, right? This bonobos, this is very rare. This is found in just maybe a couple of forests of Africa, right? So like this is it. Like what major thing happened is from here only another species evolved, and this is what is important, right? From here only there is evolution of what? Evolution of a species which could walk on two legs. Now we still are not very sure about this particular aspect, but we did found some fossil a few years ago in some parts of Africa, in the Ethiopian region of Africa, and it is very famously known as Lucy, the Lucy fossil, right? So it was actually a fossil of a female, right? And there were almost conclusive proof that this species could almost walk on two legs, right? So like walking on two legs, this phenomena is known as bipedalism, right? So this species was bipedalism. So scientifically they call this as Australopithecus. So we can say that from apes only we have first ape man, and we call it Australopithecus. In some text you could also find this as Australopithecine, right? So I think they are more or less the same thing. So you can do with Australopithecus also as far as geology is concerned, right? So these are the first hominid fossil, right? These are the first hominid fossils, right? So they had a bipedal locomotion. So what happened from this? Like there is a All right, so from here, what happens is from this Australopithecus, sorry, from this Australopithecus, what happens is there emerged a new genus, which is known as Homo. Like the genus Homo, it evolved from this Australopithecus. So the importance of Homo were they were bipedal plus they could make tool. So they are known as tool makers. Right? Tool makers means they were, since they were bipedal, they have their hands free to do all kind of khurafat. Like they could make this, what we call it, they could make spear, they could make, you know, weapons, sharp weapons, which they can use to kill animal and, you know, increase the availability of calories, meat, right? With time, they also control fire using their hands. So this is like the evolution start. So from here, like let me make it a bit more. I'll rub it. I'll make it again for your revision, and then we will proceed, right? Or better, we will use a new page. Right. So, what we have till now, we have in this Cretaceous tertiary times, we have a very rodent like ancestor, right? We have a rodent like ancestor. Like so this we can say as the common ancestor of mammal, of all the mammals, right? From here evolved the first primates. From primates evolved the monkey like ancestors. Like they are not modern monkey, but they were monkey like ancestors, and from them evolved the modern monkey, right? From here also evolved in a different lineage. What evolved were apes, right? So apes, we have the gorillas, the modern gorillas, we have, you know, what we have chimpanzees, we have orangutan, right? So we have gorilla, we have orangutan, we have chimpanzees, and we also have bonobos. We discussed about it, and from here only they are developed what the Lucy fossil species, like, right? So we call it Australopithecus. It is also known as Australopithecine. So what is its significance? It is basically a link between the apes and the modern humans. It is sometimes termed as the missing link, right? So their significance was they started to develop bipedalism. They could walk on two legs. Right. And from here, we say that from Lucy or from Australopithecus or from some of the ancestor of Australopithecus developed the genus Homo. Right. So we have Homos here. So they are known as tool maker. Tool is related to basically the weaponry, you know, which could be used in the forest, using stone, using wood, all these things. From Homo, this genus evolved. There went various lineages. Like, so one of the tree, it goes to Homo habilis. Right, Homo habilis. And then it also goes to something we call as Homo erectus. Right, so they were completely erect. They were completely bipedal, and their spinal cord was completely erect. And from Homo erectus developed, which what we call is anatomically modern humans. I hope it is clear till now, right? So like this is the basically the evolutionary. This is an overview of what actually is happening. So evolution is a bit more complicated. There are more web going through. There are more species. Some species are not even known today. But this is something which we can write in exam, and this is more or less a complete picture of what was actually happening. Obviously, from Homo erectus, there are some debates. Some says that not long ago, just 30 to 50,000 years ago from now on, we have some other species of humans also, right? So like we talked about Neanderthals. You must have heard about them, maybe. Neanderthals. So these species or these human species, they were found in the Neanderthal Valley of the Germany, right? Similarly, we have some other. We have Cro-Magnon. Which is found in the Cro-Magnon, that is in the France, right? We have some other also. We have Java man. It was discovered in Java. We have Peking man, discovered somewhere near in Peking, right? So we have this. So okay, this is something which. So I hope you understand what is actually happening. So like just as an short overview, so we have this first mammal, rodent-like mammal. It could be termed as common ancestor of all the mammals. From this evolved the first primates, like the monkey-like looking earliest ancestors of ours. So we call them primates. From primates developed like monkey-like ancestor, and from this monkey-like ancestor developed the modern monkey, right? So you must have seen the modern monkeys, right? And from here a different lineage, it developed to apes. So you can see these modern monkeys, these are not our ancestors, right? They are, this is a different branch. Our lineage is coming this way, right? Which way? Homo erectus, say, and then here. This is our lineage coming. So these modern monkeys, they are not our ancestors, right? So from this apes developed CGO, CGO. C is for chimpanzees, G is for gorillas, orangutans, and also the bonobos, right? And from here developed the first species which could walk on its two legs. Bipedal locomotion, and we call it Australopithecus, right? From Australopithecus developed the most important Homo genus. We have Homo habilis and Homo erectus, and from Homo erectus we have anatomically modern humans, right? So like there was a question in the class that said, why do we call them anatomically modern human? So we call them anatomically modern because like DNA wise they look like us. The anatomy is pretty similar. Like in them and in modern humans, there is not much difference DNA wise. The anatomy is almost similar. But what is difference is the culture. Now, they might not be as sophisticated as modern human in terms of language, in terms of cultural aspects. So this is something which is in terms of economic, in terms of the way they live, right? In all these things. So this is the difference. Cultural differences are there. So that is how. So this is something in full overview. And now we'll just go through in detail of this, and that's it. We will be done with this topic, right? So like this is again a slide. Here I just want to give you a timeline. Now, if you are interested, you can also jot down the timeline that when all this is happening. So this first ape-like species, it occurred somewhere around just 7 million years ago from today, right? So this is the ape. This Lucy we talk about, when we dated its age, it came out like they are still not complete understanding between the scientists about the real age. Some say that it is somewhere around 3.2 million. Some say that no, it is older. Some say that it is younger. So like you can write it 2 to 4 million years ago, right? Even you can write 3 और 2 million ईयर अगो अपियर द फर्स्ट स्पीशीज विच कुड वॉक ऑन इट्स 2 leg विच हैड बाइपेडल लोकोमोशन. सो समवेयर अराउंड 2 million ईयर, राइट, दिस लूसी वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट 2 to 3 million ईयर अगो, राइट. देन वी हैव होमो हैबिलिस, इट इज समवेयर अराउंड 1.5 million, राइट. दिस वॉज 2 million, दिस इज 1.5 million. देन वी हैव होमो इरेक्टस समवेयर स्मॉलर देन 1.4. सो हियर फ्रॉम वेरियस सोर्सेज आई हैव रिटन 1.8 to 1.3. सो जस्ट रिमेंबर इट इज 1.5, इट इज 1.4, राइट. एंड फ्रॉम दीज होमो इरेक्टस इवॉल्व एनाटोकली एनाटॉमिकली मॉडर्न ह्यूमन. सो दे आर जस्ट लाइक 0.2 million ईयर ओल्ड. सो दे फर्स्ट अपियर जस्ट 2 lakh ईयर अगो ऑन प्लैनेट अर्थ, राइट. सो वी आर, वी मॉडर्न ह्यूमन आर वेरी वेरी यंग विज वी द हिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्थ, राइट. द अर्थ हिस्ट्री इज लाइक टू मच, इट इज 4.4600 million ईयर ओल्ड एंड वी आर जस्ट 0.2 million ईयर. सो वी कंप्राइज अ बिल्कुल टाइनी टाइनी पार्ट ऑफ अर्थ हिस्ट्री, right, the modern humans. And similarly we have Neanderthals, right, they got extinct around 30,000 years ago and they appeared somewhere around 6 to 3 lakhs, like they appeared earlier than us but they got extinct some 30,000 years ago according to various theories, right. So I hope you understand this. You should draw this diagram in your copies for an overview. And in exam, you can draw either this diagram or you can draw it, you know, in a vertical manner. So something like this which we discussed. Now, I hope this diagram would be more clearer to you. Wait, it will come again. But I just want to tell you here, the importance of this diagram is here. You don't have to worry much about the timeline. See, so what I did is, you are writing various species and how they are evolving, right? But you have also written this simple. If you remember the various epoch of Cenozoic time, you just write from Paleocene, Eocene, I think Oligocene is missing somewhere, Miocene, Pliocene, Pleistocene, present. And you know, if you make a bit mistake also, now if you write if you write this maybe Ramapithecus somewhere here also, it is fine, right? You won't be in a subjective exam like UPSC, you won't be much penalized on this thing. So it just simplify it. It also gives a good timeline when this evolved, and you just have to write something here, right? You just have to write the name and then you can jot down something like, you know, Australopithecus, you can say the fossil Lucy is an example of it. It was one of the first to develop bipedalism, like something like this. From Australopithecus we have Homo habilis, like it is missing in this diagram, Homo habilis. Then we have Homo erectus. From Homo erectus we got Homo sapiens, but then there were some 5-6 more cousins of ours which was present few thousand years ago but which got extinct, right? So that include Cro-Magnon, Java man, then we have, you know, Peking man, we have Neanderthals, all these. So we'll come back on this when we we'll have a detailed study of all this, right? And then we'll come back on it. So like this is official, this is a formal first slide, first lecture. Till now I just use my handwritten notes which are unfortunately in a bad handwriting, but they were also very helpful. They will give you some idea about how you have to write an exam. So like just this is the first slide. This is just a random slide taken from Google. So you first think and write in your copy what changes are happening, right? Here this is Australopithecus. From Australopithecus, we get Homo habilis, Homo erectus, then Homo sapiens, Neanderthals, right? Then Homo. First thing you should observe that evolution is not so simple, right? So, like here, it is written that Australopithecus, we get Homo habilis, from there, we get Homo erectus. This is not the case, right? Like we discussed here, from Australopithecus, we get this homogenous. From one lineage goes to Homo habilis and another goes to Homo erectus. So it is not linear. Writing it like Homo habilis to Homo erectus to Homo sapiens, this is not the right thing, right? But this is just an introductory slide, so ignore this aspect, but know what I mean to say. So like just see what इज द इवोल्यूशनरी ट्रेंड. अवर टॉपिक इज व्हाट चेंजेस आर टेकिंग प्लेस, व्हाट इज द इवोल्यूशनरी ट्रेंड इन ह्यूमंस, राइट. सो दीज आर डिफरेंट स्पीशीज, दिस इज मॉडर्न ह्यूमन. सो व्हाट चेंजेस आर हैपनिंग, जस्ट सी द पिक्चर एंड टेल टेल राइट इन योर कॉपी. सिंस दिस इज अ रिकॉर्डिंग रिकॉर्डेड क्लास, यू कैन नॉट टेल, सो राइट दिस इन योर कॉपी. So, like you can see, what firstly this diagram is showing that the brain size is increasing. Generally, the brain size is increasing, right? You can also see that the bipedalism, all of them are bipedal, but you can see that this is one of the most erect species. Like the posture is getting erect. The posture is getting erect with time. This is one of the changes, right? You can also say that there is a change in the jaw, and here the jaw is more flatter. The jaw is getting flatter, and in the earlier species it is more protruded. What other changes? You can also say that the body hairs are decreasing. Right. So, like these are some very basics. So, this is what we are going to study. This is what we will be studying. What evolutionary changes are happening? What is the trend in various things? Right. So, like again, this we covered. This is just biological classification hierarchy or the taxonomy. So, you don't have to go in detail of all this. You can just remember we did it. The species is the Homo sapiens. Like it is about humans. So, you can remember this for man, elephant, and horse. Because these are mentioned in our syllabus. So we are homogenous, families hominidae, right? Don't have to remember suborder. Order is primate, class is mammalia, right? Ignore all this. Phylum is chordata and kingdom is animalia. So this is something you can remember. Maybe if you are writing an objective geology exam, then you might want to give a look at this column also. But this is not that important for our exam, right? So like this is again a family portrait. So again, like evolution is not that easy. Evolution is not that straightforward or linear. It has a lot of web, a lot of linkages. So it is a very simplistic diagram. But just for your understanding, you can say that these were the earliest mammals. You can see these are the mammals which are arboreal. What is arboreal? Arboreal means the one which lives on tree. Right, which may live, which may eat some insect, maybe some fruits, but it lives on tree. So from this arboreal species, we got this monkey-like ancestor. Like we have gibbons. Gibbons is one of the ape which is found in India. It is the only ape which is found in India. We have this orangutan, chimpanzees, gorillas. So this is bonobos. So this is what apes. Right. So from this primitive monkey, we have modern monkey, and we have apes. Right. So these are two different branches, modern monkeys and apes, from the primitive monkey-like species. From these apes, chimpanzees also, we have the earliest bipedal apes, which we call them Australopithecus. Like I hope this slide is visible to you all. And from Australopithecus, we have Homo habilis, we have Homo erectus, and we have modern humans, right? So this is a very simplistic way of understanding it. Right. So again, if you have to write an exam and you have to define what is human evolution, you can define human evolution in your own way. Right. So what is human evolution? We talk about a evolutionary process that led to the emergence of anatomically modern humans. From whom? From primates, right? So this is human evolution, is evolutionary process that led to the emergence of anatomically modern humans, beginning the evolution with the history of primates. To from primates we get what? From primates we get Homo. The most important and most like the turning point in the evolution was the genus Homo. Right, something like this, and from there we have anatomically modern man. And in this process, there were various changes, like bipedalism happened, changes in the cultural development, language developed, right? All these things developed. We started to, you know, control fire, we started to make tools, all these things, right? So this is it. And then there is a slide. I don't think UPS is going to ask this. What are the similarities between apes and humans? Like, so we know what are apes. Apes are CGO, chimpanzees, gorilla, orangutan, bonobos, all these things, the gibbons. So what are some similarities in them and what are some differences in them? This is just for your general understanding. This might not be directly asked in the exam, but still you can yourself make out, right? So what are the similarities? They both don't have tail, right? So monkeys have tails. So like losing tail is an evolutionary advantage. Tail does have some its own advantage, but it does have some its disadvantages. Like if you are in a fight, this tail could be a weak point of yours. Like it could be grabbed by your opponent from a distance and then you will be in trouble. So that is an evolutionary adaptation. Then the similarities is both have relatively harder, relatively larger neck, and a relatively larger head. Then there is this broadening the chest due to flattening of sternum. So sternum is basically the outermost bone of your chest, something like this. Then, you know, reducing the number of the lumbar vertebrae, that is your backbone, right? Obviously, brain size is increasing, relatively large brain size. So brain size in human is more than apes, but they both have larger brain size than their ancestors, their primitive ancestors. And then this is this, they have both have prominent brow ridges above the eyes. You can see this diagram. Both have this brow ridges, right? So this is it. So this is more prominent in apes. This is more prominent in apes and less prominent in humans, right? Since they have vocal means of communication, right? They have development of various muscles, and very important, both have opposable thumb. Like, what is opposable thumb? That it is the ability of thumb to, you know, move in all the direction. So it is very important evolution point of view because it help you to use tools, it helps you to maneuver, it helps you to grasp things, right? So it is a very important and a very advantageous evolutionary change. And then all the primates, all the apes and all the humans, they have menstrual cycle, right? So like in other species, what is there in other species? You must be aware that they have what we call as estrous cycle, right? So what is the difference between these two? Like in menstrual cycle, the female is receptive for almost all the time for throughout the year, but in this estrous cycle, it is not available throughout the year. It is available in certain seasons. We call them breeding season. Right. So like this is a difference between these two, right? Similarly, what are the differences? Apes have less erect posture. Humans have, you know, fully erect. This hominidae have fully erect posture. Their brow ridges, we just discussed, they are more prominent. These are not so prominent. Like they still have a marked chin. Ours is not that marked. Some of them are herbivorous. Some of them are omnivorous. Humans are mostly omnivorous, right? The locomotion is bipedal. Their locomotion is also bipedal, but like their locomotion of apes is still quadruple, right? Like mostly they use all the four limbs to walk. They can stand on two legs also. They can even walk on two legs, but that is generally not the primary mode of locomotion, right? Then jaws are protruded, not so protruded. They have large incisors and canines. Like, so the dental structure is also different. So these incisors and canines, these are kind of teeth. Like, so generally there are four kinds of teeth. One, we have incisor. Second, we have canines. Third, we have like what we have. We have premolars and we have molars. So these two are generally used for cutting and tearing. And these are molars. These are generally used for what? These are used for grinding, chewing, right? That's it. And this is the last thing which we will cover in this part, that is the origin of humans. So like there were earlier, there was a theory that humans origin humans evolved, or they first originated somewhere near this, in this Pakistan, India, Nepal and China region, right? So this Dryopithecus is one of the oldest fossil which evolved into apes and humans. Like, so just remember this name, Dryopithecus. It is one of the oldest. It is one of the oldest fossil. So even in the Shivaliks, you all know what is Shivalik? Shivalik is a part of the Himalayas mountain. It is the southernmost range of the Himalayas. Like not so great in height, and most the younger one. Right. So we'll study about it more in detail, about its paleontology, about its stratigraphy and its formation in stratigraphy. So this Shivaliks, it is a heaven for vertebrate paleontology. So we have yielded a lot of earliest human fossil, right? Fossil of human ancestor in this area, right? So like we have a fossil which we also discussed earlier, which is known as Ramapithecus. Like some scholar call it Shivapithecus. They name it Shivapithecus. And some scholars in their book, they even write it as Brahmapithecus. It is more or less the same species, right? So earlier it was named as Ramapithecus. Maybe like these all are the names of the Indian gods, right? So maybe the Lord Rama, the Ayodhya is not much far away from the Shivaliks, and also Lord Rama is also related to army of like a monkey army. So in that way they named it Ramapithecus, and then they named it Shivapithecus, Shiva from the Shivaliks mountains, right? So this is also one of the earliest fossil. So there were speculation that India or the region near India, they are the cradle of human civilization, and from here the first human species, you know, it appeared and it evolved, right? So this was one of the earlier theory. Like, but the most modern theory, they conclusively says that the modern or the present human, they first appeared and they evolved in the Africa, right? Somewhere around this area. This is what? This is the East African Rift. In East African Rift. Right, or it is also known as, famously known as Afar region, the modern Ethiopia. Right, so we have a lot of, like we discussed about Australopithecine, then we have some other species, they were found in some other fossil, they were found in Tanzania, South Africa, and further till even this part. So now, according to the mitochondrial DNA studies, humans evolved in Africa, right? So this is more or less conclusive, but there are still a lot of debates, a lot of research going on all these things. But as a geology optional student, we don't have to go in all those details. We need to maximize our marks, right? We need to, like, there will be a 20 or 25 mark question on this. We just need to ensure that we score 80 to 90% in them. For that, we need to write maximum keyword, maximum information, and we should try that. We should avoid unnecessary controversies. So like this is a accepted viewpoint, right? So this is it. And then one more thing, just like we discussed in the first picture, the trends in human civilization, the same thing is summarized here in this slide, right? So like what are the trends in human evolution? Like we discussed, there is an increase in the height, there is attainment of the erect posture, very important, bipedal locomotion is happening, right? With time, brain size is increasing. Like this is brain size is increasing with time. Like also intelligence is increasing. Then there is broadening and elevation of forehead, reduction in body language, reduction in body hair. Like then we have this narrowing and elevation of nose, formation of chin, reduction of brow ridges, all these things like we have discussed. Similarly, development of bowel like pelvic girdle. So like this is primarily really related to holding of the pregnancy, right? So these are all evolutionary change trends happening in the human इवोल्यूशन. सो यू कैन यू शुड राइट दिस इन एग्जाम. सो इफ समबडी इज आस्किंग दिस क्वेश्चन, ऑलवेज ड्रॉ द डायग्राम विच यू डिस्कस इन द फर्स्ट स्लाइड, द ह्यूमन इवोल्यूशन फाइलोजेनेटिक डायग्राम. आफ्टर दैट स्क्रब समथिंग ऑन दैट डायग्राम एंड इफ इट इज अ 25 मार्कर, राइट ऑल दिस पॉइंट्स. वॉट आर द ट्रेंड्स इन ह्यूमन इवोल्यूशन? दीज आर ऑल द ट्रेंड्स हैपनिंग. मे बी इफ यू हैव सम डेटा अबाउट ब्रेन साइज, राइट इट डेटा दैट वी विल कवर इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. राइट, सिमिलरली लाइक दिस इज वॉट इज हैपनिंग. सो आई थिंक वी विल स्टॉप इट हियर. फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट, वी विल स्टडी दिस डायग्राम इन डिटेल. राइट, वॉट वी विल डू इज वी विल पिक अप ईच स्पीशीज, वी विल पिक अप प्रॉपर आयोपिथेकस एंड वी विल डिस्कस वॉट आर इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक एंड देन हाउ चेंजेस हैपेंड एंड इट फॉर्म्ड इनटू कैनेंथ्रोपस और प्रोकोन्सुल समथिंग लाइक दैट. हाउ देन वी गॉट ड्रायोपिथेकस, वन ऑफ द लाइक वी डिस्कस इट इज वन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट फॉसिल टू बी डिस्कवर्ड. सो वॉट आर इट्स फीचर्स, हाउ इट लुक लाइक, हाउ एंड हाउ इट इवॉल्व इंटू यू नो दिस मॉडर्न एप्स एंड वन लीनेज वेंट टू दिस रामापिथेकस विच इज फाउंड इन शिवालिक्स एंड अबाउट लूसी राइट द ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस स्पीशीज होमो इरेक्टस होमो हैबिलिस होमो सेपियंस. सो फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल पिक अप वेरी ब्रीफली समथिंग अबाउट दैम. वी विल ऑल्सो टॉक अबाउट ब्रेनियल ब्रेन कैपेसिटी एंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स, एडवांटेज ऑफ मोर एडवांटेज ऑफ बाइपेडलिज्म, ऑल दिस थिंग्स. सो दिस इज इट. सो आई थिंक वील एंड द क्लास हियर टुडे एंड देन वील हैव नेक्स्ट सेशन टुमारो.